As Cameroon enters the fifth year of civil war, refugees who escaped the conflict have curated Humans of the Forgotten War, a photo exhibition that raises awareness of their plight through art.
For me, the exciting part was really just putting on the clothing and apparel, because it made me feel as if I was putting on armor to help the conflict myself. And to help all the children, not only of the African region, but all the children of the world facing conflict at home.
It's difficult for a woman being to see what is happening in our country and keep quiet.
Cameroon was a British territory, then a German colony, that was divided after the First World War, with the English-speaking region placed under a French-speaking rule. Years of dissatisfaction at the two-system country sparked a teachers' and lawyers' strike in 2016 against the erosion of the English language and culture from classrooms. Security forces responded violently, leading communities to rise up against the Francophone government. 5 years later, thousands are missing and millions have fled what has been called a forgotten war.
We don't have a family home. It was destroyed by the military.
We were in the village and suddenly we heard gunshots. My father took us to the bull shelter for safety. The next day, when the military came in and started beating the civilians, my father was one of them. My mother now took us from our village. I miss my friends and I also miss my grandmother.
You are not supposed to talk. You don't have an opinion. They will catch you up. They will lock you.
This photo shoot took place on Constitution Hill, a symbolic prison site in the city of Johannesburg, South Africa, to represent not only the thousands of Cameroonians imprisoned since the start of this war, but more so the power of forgiveness.
The outfits we are wearing are Bamenda traditional clothing, so the colours were green, yellow and red, representing the Cameroon flag. And we use the South African colours as a backdrop to show you that when communities help each other, a lot of great things can happen.
I put on a mask to represent the faceless children who have been displaced from their homes.
Children are dying there.
With violence escalating, schools have been forced to close as teachers and students were increasingly being targeted, kidnapped, and even killed.
What I've seen was quite scary, actually. Over 70% of kids cannot go to school anymore because of the conflict, which means they are losing education.
I was in junior secondary one. The military came into our house. We left from Mamfe to Bisonghabang and we ran into the bushes. We walked for 2 days. We arrived on Sunday, the 9th of September, 2018.
As a child of a slave, you grow up thinking that slavery is a normal thing.
In 2020, for the first time, the government of Cameroon initiated negotiations to bring about a ceasefire. But there remain unresolved issues on all sides to make way for people to go back home.
Nobody should go through that.
It was very overwhelming.
The best thing about taking part is the thought and accomplishment that some people will be helped by our small contribution.